Good morning all. I thought I'd just make a few alterations to the buck converter that I've been playing with recently. So I'm just creating a little link wire to go across here, same as that one there, just so that I can complete the circuit with a switch, which is a MOSFET inductor, load, which is a lamp, and the diode in the middle there. So I've just cut a little piece of wire, just strip the two ends off. Oh, have I made that a bit short? Oh, well, it's a little shorter than that one, but it doesn't really matter. None of these dimensions are particularly accurate, particularly that one in the top left-hand corner. So I just crimp these spade terminals onto the end. I'll just use my cutters for this. Just squeeze that down onto there. And then feed some solder in from this right-hand side and solder that on. Strange beeping noise, but actually I think it's this soldering iron thing. I'll just touch the phone onto it. Yeah, I think the sound is actually coming from that thing. It's a sort of oscillating, buzzing noise. Right, so that's another little linking wire made up. So I'm just going to put that in there. Really, it's cosmetic. It just so that this thing looks a bit neater. Good. Okay, so that's the buck regulator made up with nice, neat wires. Right, so let's power this thing up. I need 5-volt USB for the Arduino, which provides the pulse width modulation signal. I think that's set at 50%. Not quite. Let's set that at 50%. So that we're switching this MOSFET on and off with equal time intervals. Okay, I'm going to need 12 volts, which is currently 12.5. That's a bit low. It is completely cloudy today, so there's no sun. Right, so I've got 10 volts output here. I turned it down a bit last night because I only had 12.5 volts on my batteries, and setting this to 12, it was actually pulling a bit low, which didn't make a lot of sense. Right, let's switch that on. So there's the lamp coming on at half brightness. Let's look at voltage. 10 volts there, and I can vary the brightness up to full and down to zero. Now, who was it that said in the last video that this wasn't really or may not be a buck converter? It may just be simply that I'm doing pulse width modulation on the lamp and therefore varying its brightness, which of course would work if we didn't have the inductor, we didn't have the diode, and I just simply pulse width modulated the power from this power supply through to the lamp. Yes, we'd have brightness control in much the same way. Yeah, so who was it? Jay Heard. So far it just looks like PWM. I suspect Lawrence L, as others, that a scope would prove that there's no bucking going on presently, just amplified PWM. You're basically using PWM, Alessandro Riva. If you remove the inductor and the diode, yeah, so basically it was everyone said that it probably isn't really doing much bucking. It's just PWM. Well, let's have a look. Right, okay, so let's take this lamp off. Let's take the inductor out, which I can do like that. The power's still on, I should turn that off, I suppose. Let's take out this diode, take out my new little link wire that I've just made. Take out the diode if I can get it out. Yeah, bent it a bit. And just fix the bulb here so that all we've got in the circuit is the MOSFET switch and the load. Right, now so probably take this out as well because that circuit diagram no longer applies, because all we've got here is simply a power supply, a switch which I'm switching on and off at very high frequency. This was 31 kilohertz, I seem to remember, and the lamp. So let's turn on the power supply. So yes, there's the lamp at sort of mid brightness, and if I turn up the pulse width modulation, so we've got a higher mark space ratio. Oh yeah, it gets brighter. And if I turn it down, it goes off. So yes, you can control the brightness of this lamp just with PWM. You don't need all this buck converter stuff. However, it doesn't mean that this isn't buck converting. It just means that it works just as well without the buck converter components as with them. So I'm going to put them back because I want to see if there's another way I can determine whether or not this buck converter circuit is actually doing a DC to DC conversion. Right, so I've put all the components of the buck regulator back, inductor, diode, and we're still getting brightness control there. That's working very nicely. Of course, the other way I can take the buck converter components out of circuit is just to short out with this little link wire the inductor. Now, if I do that, you'll notice that the bulb gets a little bit brighter. I'm not entirely sure why that is. The diode, of course, if there's no inductive component in here, doesn't do anything because the positive side of the circuit is never going to go more negative than the negative side of the circuit. So this diode is effectively now useless. And of course, with the inductor shorted out, as we've seen, this works just as a pure pulse width modulator. And I can vary brightness like that. But with the inductor back in circuit, is it working as a buck converter? Well, let's just have a look for a moment at something which does a similar job, although a transformer, of course, does a DC to DC. No, not DC. That was wrong. A transformer, of course, does an AC to AC voltage conversion. This one you can see is marked 0, 120 volts, 0, 120 volts. So it's got a split primary. It's also marked 0606. I'm not sure what that middle pin does. So essentially what this is a 240 volts AC to 12 volts AC converter or transformer. It transforms 240 volts down to 12 volts. So that's a 20-to-1 voltage reduction. Now, of course, the power that flows through this transformer is reasonably well held, I suppose you could say. It's maintained. So the power in watts, is not so dissimilar from the power out. Yes, you'll get a little bit less power out because some of the watts going through the transformer will be consumed in heat. The transformer will warm up. And a tiny little bit might be consumed making the sound, the buzzing sound that a transformer makes. A small amount of power will be lost in mechanical vibration. But you might expect, I don't know, better than 90% of the 240, no, not volts, we're talking watts now, aren't we, of the power going in to be available as power coming out. Now, if we've got a 20-to-1 reduction in voltage from 240 down to 12, what are we going to get in terms of current? Well, the current in the secondary circuit is going to be higher than the current in the primary circuit. The voltage is transformed down, the current is transformed up. So a transformer has current gain. We actually get more current flowing in the secondary circuit than we have flowing in the primary circuit because power is reasonably well maintained from primary to secondary. Voltage is stepped down, therefore current is stepped up. So we could check whether this circuit is actually working by looking for current gain. So what I want to do is I want to look at current flowing in the primary side of this circuit. Now, the primary side is when the MOSFET is switched on. Current's going to flow through the MOSFET, through the inductor, or at least it will build up in the inductor, through the load and back down to the power supply. That's the primary side circuit. And then when the MOSFET switches off, we've actually got a secondary side circuit, which is just these three components, the diode, the inductor and the lamp. And a current will flow around that secondary circuit. So I can measure the current in the primary side circuit. In fact, I'm doing it now. It's 139 milliamps. What I want to be able to do is measure current in the secondary side circuit. So I'm actually going to take back out this link, what I just made. And I'm going to fit this, which I've also made up. And this is an ammeter. This is my little Arduino OLED ammeter. And I'm going to stick that in the secondary side of this circuit and measure the current and see if we get current gain. Right, so let's build the tension here. I'm going to short out the inductor to start with, so that this is simply a pulse width modulation switching circuit. Right, now let's push this battery in. I think if I just shove it in like that, it should start working. And check the current in the primary side of the circuit and current in the secondary side of the circuit. And although this is jumping around a bit, which it would because of course we're switching this MOSFET on and off, I think you can see that they're pretty similar. So without the inductor, if we're just using this as a pulse width modulation system to control the brightness, current on the input side is very similar to current on the output side. Yeah, that is bouncing around a bit. Let's turn this up to 100% PWM. Now everything's going to go completely stable because we're not switching the MOSFET. That MOSFET is now on, just permanently on. And the other thing I wanted to check was whether these two ammeters agree, and they're not far out. So this ammeter is saying about 300 milliamps. This one's saying not dissimilar to that. Of course, the other place where they're going to agree, well, they're both going to agree all the time, actually, at the moment with the inductor removed, is with 0 PWM, 0%. So this MOSFET is now completely off. There's no current flowing in the circuit. This one says zero. This one says less than 1 milliamp, so that we can treat as zero. So let's put this back to 50%. That's there. We've got roughly the same current in the input side of the circuit as the output. Possibly looks like marginally more in the output side of the circuit. So the big reveal is what will happen when I put the inductor back in circuit. So let's take off this link wire. Do we get current gain? Yes, you can see that the input current actually went down. Let's do that again, because I didn't see it. So we've got 180 milliamps here. Yeah, about 180 milliamps there as well. Take this link out. I can't just pull it, it won't work. And the input current has actually dropped to 143 milliamps. The output current is around about 190 milliamps. So there it is, we've got current gain. There's more current flowing into that lamp than is actually coming out of this power supply. We've got a voltage step down. You can see that the voltage on the output is less than the voltage on the input. Oh yeah, that was something else people criticized me for, not showing the voltage on the output. I mean, you don't really need to show it because the brightness of the lamp indicates that the voltage is lower. If you put a lower voltage on a lamp, it's going to be dimmer, but I'll get my DVM in a moment anyway, and we'll see whether at 50% PWM, which would be exactly with that pot aligned that way, whether we get half the voltage. What's the voltage on the input? 10 volts. Whether we get 5 volts on the lamp. Well, I'll check that now, actually. Right, so here's my DVM. Let's plug. I've only got a yellow wire for some odd reason. Into positive and the black wire into negative. And what have we got? Oh, well, that's not bad, is it? 4.85 volts. Let's tweak the pot. Let's turn that up a bit. 6 volts. Well, that's pretty close to 5 volts. Let's get that exactly onto 5 volts. So that's about 5 volts. And you can see that the pot is almost exactly halfway. So we're transforming, we're converting 10 volts down to 5 volts. We're also increasing the current on the output side to about 190 milliamps from only 144 milliamps on the input side. Now, you'd think, wouldn't you, that we'd get, as we transform the voltage down by a half, we'd get the voltage, the current would double. But of course, there are massive inefficiencies in this circuit. Not least of which is the fact that the driving wave wasn't anything like square. It was very distorted. So this MOSFET is spending quite a lot of time. Let's see if it's warm. Not really. But it's spending quite a bit of time in its linear region. It's not switching hard from on to off. So yeah, we're getting pretty poor efficiency here because the current gain is not 2:1. But we are getting current gain. So this is a buck converter. Now, someone else who I shan't name because They said that this isn't a DC to DC converter because it doesn't regulate. And no, it doesn't regulate. It simply converts. It simply transforms the input voltage, which is 10 volts, down to something less. 3 volts there, 7 volts there. It's a transformer. It's exactly the same as this. If you change the input voltage, the AC input voltage on a transformer, then your AC output voltage will change. It's ratiometric. So there's a 20 to 1 transforming ratio here. There are probably 20 times as many turns on the primary as there are turns of wire on the secondary. So you get a 20 to 1 reduction. It's not regulated. The output of a transformer is not regulated. And the output of this buck converter is not regulated. It's a buck converter. It's not a buck regulator. So, yeah, the buck converter is working. It works as a voltage step-down device. We're stepping this 10 volts down to 5 volts on the output. And it works as a current step-up device. We're stepping this 144 milliamps up to, well, around 190 milliamps. That's not a very good current step-up, but it is doing it. So we've got some pretty bad losses in this circuit. So it's a DC to DC converter. We get voltage step down and current step up. And we can determine that just with some fairly simple measuring devices, in this case, voltmeters and ammeters. Now we can probably see much better what's going on here if I get the oscilloscope out. I didn't want to do that today. I wanted to see if I could do this just with these measuring devices. But maybe next time I will get the scope out. Cheerio.